humans are unable to talk to each other and their eyes are nowhere near our human eyes. So how do they communicate with each other? When presented with the word communication, most humans will probably associate it with language or speech, something spoken created by the use of our tongue and mouth to shape and articulate. This way, we can create an infinite amount of words and as a result tell extremely complex stories. The communication of ants is not quite as advanced, but most people would probably agree that it is impressive refined. An ant colony can consist of several million of workers. How does an ant society actually function? How can such a large society be this well organized? How do they communicate? And what will happen if ants have the humor like humans? Here is the today's knowledge of ants. Ants communicate through body language. Just as humans, the ants use body language to communicate things. They can tell the other ants things by lightly touching or stroking the receiver in different ways. This way, they can combine signals of pheromones with that of touch and body language, providing an advanced form of communication. One example is when the ants, by lightly pressing a section of another ant's head, can produce a jaw reflex, giving the first ant the opportunity to taste the diet of the other ant. It is not uncommon for ants to save some of their food for later or for members of the colony. Ants secrete substances called pheromones, which are chemical messages detected by other ants through sense organs or the antennae. How ants communicate through motion and touch. The ants tend to lay out scent trails to food sources like breadcrumbs for other workers to find and follow. When a single worker has found something, she will run back to the colony while sprinkling small drops of pheromones on the ground for other workers to follow. Their myrmecologists explain that there are five different ways the ants can mix and vary these signals. When a worker ant meets a member of the colony, she can tell it things by moving her body in a specific manner, or simply by the touching of antennae. The other ant is then provided with a relatively clear image of what it should look for at the end of the trial. If the first ant has found something edible, she will most likely give the other ant a taste of it from a sample out of her mouth. Do ants speak to each other? Yes. Another peculiar way of how ants communicate is by sound. A majority of ant species use it to communicate, although it is commonly unknown to most people because of its low resonance. The ants can procure different sounds by scraping their legs in a washboard-like part of their body, thus accomplishing different sounds. Although we may not hear it, other ants can. The sound is actually possible for us to perceive if we hold an ant very close to the ear, listening carefully. These sounds are used in different ways depending on the species. A great example of the use of sound is when a worker ant has been trapped somewhere, maybe through the collapse of a tunnel or chamber blocking all the exits. The ant can use sound as a distress call, signaling their location to the other workers through the walls. This could not be achieved by pheromones. Humor like humans. Ants don't have complex emotions such as love, anger, or empathy, but they do approach things they find pleasant and avoid the unpleasant. So if they had humor like humans, it will be disastrous for the world. It is quite really possible that there will be a war between humans and ants, but surely ants are going to win because of non-human behavior. Ants are aggressive, often raiding other ant colonies, fighting to the death, and snapping off limbs, heads, and body parts of enemies with their strong, sharp mandibles. So when they are going to think like a human, it will be take them to the next level.